नेक्स्ट पार्ट विल गो फॉर द फेजेस ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट. बेसिकली देर आर थ्री फेजेस ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट. प्री प्रोजेक्ट फेज दैट इज इंक्लूड्स द प्लानिंग ऑफ ए प्रोजेक्ट. नेक्स्ट फेज इज अ प्रोजेक्ट फेज विच इंक्लूड्स शेड्यूलिंग एंड इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ ए प्रोजेक्ट. एंड थर्ड वन इज द पोस्ट प्रोजेक्ट फेज विच इंक्लूड्स द कंट्रोलिंग ऑफ ए प्रोजेक्ट. ओके नेक्स्ट पार्ट just we'll go in detail of all the phases of this project. So first one is a pre-project phase, that is the planning phase. Okay, again this planning phase is divided into three parts. Okay, idea, project concept phase and feasibility. Okay, so what we want to consider under idea, so just under idea just we'll find which type of the industry or which type of industry we are going to construct. Okay, that type of the industry we are going to define. So suppose the owner is having some idea, that is he is going to construct one textile industry, or he is going to construct one plastic industry, okay, or he is going to construct for sugar industry. So which type of industry in his mind, okay, that or that idea we are going to consider under this part. Okay, so this is the first part. Next, second part is the project concept phase. So again, suppose owner is willing to construct one textile industry, then again he has to look for which type of automation level he want to go. Okay, what it means, suppose for textile industry, suppose he is having an ample amount of money, so that here he is going to expand his total industry. So far he can, suppose if he is having ample amount of money, then he can go for a high level of automation. Of course, if he is going for high level of automation, the cost for the project required will be of course more. Okay, so in this project concept phase we have to look for the automation, which level of automation we are going to consider. That part comes under the project concept phase. Of course, for this part we have to consider benefit to cost ratio. Suppose if you are going to put ample amount of money for the automation, that means of course the productivity and the quality of the product will be of course more. Okay, but at that time the investment amount is also more. Okay, so at that time we have to check what is our benefit from that product, and what is the cost we have invested for doing this total automation. So this is the concept phase. So we have to go for the benefit to cost ratio. Of course, benefit must be more as that of the cost to be invested for the total project. So it defines which level we are going to consider for automation. So next part is the feasibility. In this feasibility we are going to check the design, we will check estimate, specification and location. So what it means, so first of all we'll go for the design. So you have to check the feasibility of the design. So if the design given by the contractor consultant, if that design is we have to check the feasibility of that design. Okay, whether that design is so heavy or not, or it is so lighter. Okay, the design feasibility we have to check. Next we have to check the estimate. Just rough here we are going to find out the rough estimate of the total cost of the project. Just we are going for the rough estimate, or you can call this as a preliminary estimate. Okay, so it is not a detailed estimate. Okay, so as per the we are going to go for this particular specific type of a material, production of a different material. So for that material or for that product, which specification we have to follow, okay, that is also important. Okay, suppose if you want to go for the higher specifications for a product, that means we have to go for the higher estimate, we have to go for higher automation. So again, this feasibility also you have to check for the specification. This feasibility of this specification will consider by considering the where we are going to locate our industry. So just we'll check the in the vicinity of that industry. In the vicinity of the industry, which type of the material is available, which type of material we can, which type of the product we can sell, with what specification, that is important. Okay, so again, locality is also important. Okay, so as per this, just we'll consider these four parameters, that is design, estimate and specification and the location. Under this parameter, that is feasibility, just we'll check the feasibility of all the things. Of course, this is a first phase, that is planning. So in this, all these three things, idea, project concept phase and feasibility, all these three things are just at preliminary level. Okay, just here also we are going for approximate estimate, not we are not going for a detailed estimate. Okay, just it's a rough calculation. Okay, so it's just regarding for planning. Next phase is the project phase, which includes the scheduling and implementation. So in the first phase, we are just planning which type of industry, which type of the automation, which type of the where there is the locality of the industry. Okay, just rough things we are covered, or just we have some scratch, just we have started with the scratch in the first phase. Okay, so second phase includes a basic design. So what it means, basic design? So of course, you are in last year, you are having another subject, that is quantity survey and valuation. Okay, in that subject, we'll go through the this part, that is administrative, what is administrative role, what is technical sanction, detailed estimate. We'll go through that in that subject, that is quantity survey and valuation. Okay, but that part is required over here, so that's why I've taken here. So first of all, you have to go for a basic design. Basic design means just you have to get some administrative approval. Administrative approval means just you will put your idea, just for that idea, what is the cost required, just a rough estimate you will do. Okay, and that estimate you will put to the for approval. Suppose administratively it is approved, then you can go for the detailing of the project. If here at the time of administrative approval itself, suppose this project is getting rejected, of course we'll not go for the next phase. Okay, so first thing, just basic design, the rough design has to be sanctioned by the administrative approval. Okay, so simple. So next part is going for the detailed design. Suppose you are getting a total administrative approval, means suppose just if I take the example of a construction of an apartment. So in this case, what is what mean by administrative approval? Just at this phase, you will get NOC, no objection certificate, from the or the clearance from every department, so that you can go for the construction of an apartment or that locality. Okay, so this is the administrative approval. So next part is a detailed design. After getting this, we'll go for detailed design. In that, technical sanction will provide all the will provide a particular location, will provide the total sanction plan, the plan for the sanction. Just suppose we are going to construct again the apartment, then we'll provide it total plan of that total apartment. Okay, and that plan has to be sanctioned, that technically sanctioned by the technical authorities. Okay, so this part is to be done under the detailed design. If the technical sanction we are getting, then after we'll go for the tendering phase. Of course, in these two phases we have got the technical and administrative approval. That means we can go for a project. That means we have to call a tender, so that a different contractors will fill the tender and they can start a project. Okay, of course, for that one tender is called, this is a tendering phase. In this, detailed estimate and specification is defined in the tender. So in detailed estimate, just the location, the sanction plan, the detailed steel drawing is also mentioned over here. So it includes the detailed estimate. And again, in detailed estimate, the cost of every item, the cost of the every item and the quantity and cost of every item is defined in the detailed estimate. Okay, so that the total cost of the project is found out detailed in for every items which are involved in the project. Next part is the specification. Again, every specification is defined in the detailed estimate. Specification for everything. Suppose if you are provide a flooring, so which type of flooring you want to provide, which type of material you want to use. For suppose if you are going for the plumbing, then which type of material, which company we are going to consider for the plumbing. Okay, so all these pictures are suppose if you are going for electrification. So which type of the material you are going to consider, which company or particular company if you are going to consider that. So that is to be defined in this total detailed specification. Okay, so this covers the tendering phase. Next part is the execution. After these three phase, next part is the execution. This is actually the construction phase. Here in this phase, main part is to monitor the all activity. The contractor has to monitor all the ongoing activity. That is the important phase, or you can say you can by monitoring the all the activity, what we can do, we can check the quality. We can check the quality which of the quality of the work as well as the schedule. Okay, first thing is quality. Just we have to check the quality of the work which is going on. That we have to check whether it is going as per the detailed specification. First of all, we have defined the specification. Okay, so whether the work is going as per the specification or not, that we have to check. That comes under checking the quality of a project. Next part is the scheduling. Okay, just we have to check whether the given project is going as per the schedule or not. Okay, suppose it is not going with as per the schedule or schedule, then if it is lagging, so then you have to provide more manpower, you have to provide more material, or by using more equipment, we have to crunch this total time required. Okay, so anyhow, the important thing is you have to complete any project within stipulated time. That is important. Okay, time is more important in this case. So for that, you can allocate different resources. You can use different equipment, material, manpower. 3M, that are the more important. Okay, so again, suppose the project is lagging behind, we have to use these more resources, and by using these more resources, we will complete the given project. We'll try to complete the given project in the scheduled time. Okay, so that is, you can call this a updating of a scheduling or updating. This all we have seen previously. So that is the comes under the controlling and updating. So first part is the controlling. Control the situation. That is, suppose the project is lagging, so control that situation, and just by the extra resources control that situation. Next part is the updating. Again, you have to update the total predefined schedule. So if you update predefined schedule, then you can go for a new schedule for the execution. Okay, so last part for the from second phase is closure phase. Okay, so here the project will be completed. Okay, so at the time of closure phase, you have to get the completion certificate. completion certificate. After getting completion certificate, then and only you can say technically that the project is over. Okay. Next, after completion of this project, we have to hand over to the another. Suppose say example of a apartment. So contractor has constructed a total apartment. He will get a completion certificate. Okay. Next, he will hand over all the total apartment, that total flats, to the different owner. Okay. So that is the handover phase. Okay. It comes under the second, that is project phase. So this is the last part from project phase, that is handover. Next, the third phase. Actually, this is the third phase. That is the post project phase. That is the controlling. Post project phase. This is the third phase actually. So in this case, there are two parts: utilization phase. Of course, the flat owners of that apartment will utilize the apartment. Okay, so this is the utilization phase. Or if you consider any industry, that industry will run. So that means they are utilizing their total space. Okay, that is utilization phase. Next part is the close down phase. So of course, for every structure, there is some particular time duration is there. Okay, so suppose we are constructed one apartment, for that if you consider life of that apartment is 50 years, then after its intended life, that is after its 50 years life, it has to be dismantled by different methods. Of course, for dismantling, again, there are different methods. Okay, so that is the close down phase. So this we are going to go for after over of the its life cycle. So this is the third and last phase. Okay.